sponsored by ESR.
Are you ready to elevate your iPad experience to new heights? With iPadOS 17, Apple has just supercharged your favorite device with new features that you cannot afford to miss. Stay tuned as we dive deep into five game-changing features that are going to change the way that you use your iPad. Let's get started. What is going on, everyone? My name is Mike. Welcome back to the channel. I'm very glad that you're with me today because we are talking about five features that are coming to the iPad that are going to redefine how you use the device. Now, the iPad, undoubtedly, it's one of the most powerful devices that Apple has in its lineup. It's portable, it's highly conformable, it allows almost anyone to use it after just a few minutes of picking it up. Now today, Apple's giving its customers first look in iPadOS 17 as part of the public beta, which is available today. So if you're installing it on your device, these are gonna be the five features that I would test out if I were you, but it's gonna give the ability to kick the tires, so to speak, before this is released in the fall. Now I've been using the iPadOS 17 since it was first released at WWDC back in June. I've been using it for all my computing tasks on my 2022 M2 iPad Pro. And I'll tell you honestly, it's really solid. Now, here are my favorite features coming to iPadOS 17. Number one is gonna be personalized lock screens. Building on the success of its smaller sibling, personalized lock screens come to iPadOS 17, giving you a way to personalize your lock screen experiences and take advantage of that full big display on your iPad device. There are several new photo features that allow you to set your favorite image on your lock screen and stylize them in certain ways, including changing the typography and the color of the clock. Wow, we can finally change the color of the clock. Amazing. It's only iPadOS 17. Additionally, you can select photos from your library or choose from a collection of photos that dynamically shift throughout the day, or even a live photo that will animate when you unlock your device. Apple's added some new wallpapers, including some that already existed in iOS 16, like the Pride theme ones, Unity, Gradient, Emoji, Weather, and Astronomy, as well as some iPad exclusives, such as showing Apple's classic Hello from the original iPad in 2010. If you want to create a personalized lock screen on your device, what you do is hold your finger down on the lock screen until you get the ability to edit it. From there, you can edit the current one or make a new one and mix and match from your lock screen and your home screen, and as well as tying it to a focus mode. Number two, supercharge widgets. Widgets have been upgraded in iPadOS 17 to be more flexible, interactive, and customizable. First, you can directly interact with the widgets without needing to open the associated app. Say, for example, if I want to go ahead and check off something on my to-do list in TickTick, if I want to play a song in either Apple Music or in Spotify, or I could even control my lights using the Home app or maybe even the Hue app from right there on my screen, and I don't need to drill into the app, which is going to be this big quality of life improvement. Now, if you are enjoying today's video, like I think you are, because you're still with me, why don't you consider hitting that subscribe button right down there? Yep, that is it. And turning on notifications so you can get alerted when more content like this drops. You're not gonna be disappointed, trust me. Second, interactive widgets are now accessible from both the lock screen and the home screen, much like they are on the iPhone, providing useful information at just a glance. Now, on the lock screen, you can have a mix of small and medium-sized widgets along the left-hand side. Unfortunately, you can't move them from that location, but hey, listen, beggars can't be choosers at this point. Now, those widgets that are there on the left-hand side of the screen, they're gonna blend seamlessly into your wallpaper, and they are gonna be tinted to match your wallpaper for maximum readability. And finally, I don't know, I am super excited about this one. You can place widgets anywhere on the home screen of the iPad. It's like, oh my gosh, why has this not been here sooner? But now widgets can be placed anywhere on the home screen. You don't need to be, or they don't need to be adjacent to one of the apps. Some of the larger widgets might be confined to one of the corners, but they don't need to be anywhere on an app. You could have a screen just for, say, one widget. That's all they could do. And it could be right in the center of that screen itself. So that's great. Finally, Apple's giving us a little bit more flexibility and customization in iPadOS 17 as it comes to widgets. Today's video is brought to you by ESR, creators of the versatile Shift Magnetic Case. The Shift Magnetic Case is not just a case, it is a game changer. With this two-piece design, it offers a comprehensive protection that adapts to your dynamic lifestyle with multiple usage modes. You can experience ultimate flexibility like never before with a wide range of viewing angles from 15 to 75 degrees. The Shift Magnetic Case stands on its own, whether it's a lap or its table, ensuring stability wherever you need to take it. The exterior cover can be detached for immediate hands-on access, while the lightweight interior case provides full body protection. Now, what I personally love about the Shift Magnetic Case is the ability to use this in sidecar mode because it raises my 11-inch iPad Pro to the right height of my 11-inch, my 16-inch MacBook Pro, and it really makes using sidecar kind of effortless. And that's the thing I'm looking for, is to remove friction from my day whenever I want to use these accessories. Now, you can discover more about the Shift Magnetic Case from ESR by clicking the link down in the video description. I want to say thanks again to ESR for sponsoring today's video. Number three, express yourself better with FaceTime. iPadOS introduces a range of enhancements to FaceTime aimed at optimizing the user experience during either audio or video calls. You probably don't even remember that you can make audio calls with FaceTime, FaceTime audio. First, it's gonna be emulating the functionality of traditional voicemails. You know, it's that little notification widget that you have on your phone icon where people leave you messages telling you to call them back and you just text them back, why are you calling me? Callers can leave a recorded audio or video message when you're unavailable to take their call. Now the missed call and voicemails, you can find them either in the FaceTime app if you're on your iPad or even in the FaceTime app and on the dialer or in the phone app on the iPhone. But once you're in there, it'll show you all the calls. You have the ability to save the message, reply to a message, either with a video message or with an audio message, as well as save the message if you are the receiving party of that. So it is cool in that way. Now, I don't know about you, but voicemail is not a new thing. I do get voicemails, but they happen to be on the phone from work. I don't get a lot of personal voicemails, and I actually don't think I want people leaving me a voicemail when they try and FaceTime me. Just send me a text message. I don't know, let me know what you think down in the comments below. Second, you have a host of new reactions that are available either in FaceTime or you're gonna be your video calling platform of choice, assuming that they integrate it. But this gives you the ability to send reactions such as thumbs up, heart balloons, and fireworks. And lastly, Apple TV is getting an exciting new integration with FaceTime, which is gonna allow you to use continuity camera, which is the camera from one of your devices on the Apple television, where you can initiate a FaceTime video call from your Apple TV or start the call on your iPad and then seamlessly transition back and forth, vice versa, from one device to the other, allowing you to interact with your friends and family with the larger screen that you have in your house. It also does support center stage, where it's giving the auto framing, no matter if you're walking around the room, but I don't know about you, but I don't really walk around that much while I'm taking video calls. Now, these three features add an element of flexibility, allowing communication to occur seamlessly across all your devices and giving you an overall better experience while using FaceTime. Stage Manager was first introduced last year in iPadOS 16, and it's been reworked to allow for more fluid multitasking methods in iPadOS 17. First, the most notable is a significant increase in the freedom to arrange and resize windows, as well as to have overlapping windows. While the features are not as flexible as on a Mac, it's a considerable improvement over the original version of Stage Manager, which was limited to predetermined window sizes. This is a big, big win if you like using your iPad as a kind of more of a computer replacement, because you have a lot more flexibility with how windows are arranged, the arrangement that they're in, whether you add an additional window and whether those windows can overlap. It's really quality of life improvements, and that's, I think, the underlying theme here in iPadOS 17. Second, users can now shift-click app icons from the dock, the app library, or anywhere on their home screen, allowing them to add these apps as windows to their current workspace. Where before there was a lot of kludginess when you wanted to add a window to your workspace, you had to click on the ellipsis. Those things still exist, they're much improved, but this is a much better way of doing so. Now, the welcome change greatly improves the usability of Stage Manager on the iPad, especially when you combine it with the new freedom to resize and place windows. External camera support. Last but certainly not least, iPadOS 17 now supports external cameras and USB cameras to replace the mediocre FaceTime cameras that they have on these devices. Now, this new feature extends to various USB cameras. It doesn't matter if it's USB-C, USB-A. It even works through connected cameras. So if you have like a mirrorless camera or a DSLR, as long as it has a USB out, you can plug it into your iPad and it will automatically be recognized. It even does work with Elgato's 4K Cam Link, I believe. This also applies to those of you who have an external display, like the studio display back there. You can use the integrated webcam right on the studio display. You don't have to worry about FaceTime being kind of off center down to the left. Now, as of this video, there is only one app that supports external cameras, and that is gonna be FaceTime. That's because none of the other apps like Teams, Skype, so on and so forth, have been updated to support the iPadOS 17 frameworks. You'll need to wait until this becomes official release in the fall, but it's all gonna be there. All of your favorite apps are gonna support this service, being able to use your device with an external webcam. I'm excited. Let me know what you think down in the comments below. I wanna know what your favorite feature is. Let me know down in the comments below, or actually hit me up on Twitter where I'm a little bit more active. It's @Caputo. My name is Mike, and I will talk to you in the next one.